Next up is Emmanuel Freund. Is it good? co-founder and CEO of Blade Group, designer of Shadow, the PC from the future. I've been a customer of Shadow almost since day one. And not only have I constantly been amazed by the tech, which is pretty incredible, and I was like blown away at the time. You play online games at 60 FPS on a dematerialized PC wargaming machine, and that's really incredible. No one has been able to do that on that level before. But what also struck me as quite impressive was the sheer amount of fun and creativity around every marketing and community efforts. You should look up the video on the Shadow video on the internet. They're great, and I think Emmanuel's personality is a lot about this. So I'm super glad for you to meet Emmanuel, and I hope we'll learn and have a few loaves as well. Emmanuel, take it away.
Thanks a lot, Martial. Well, when Martial offered me to speak here, I was very humble, and I first said no, then he said I was inspiring, and then I say yes, of course, I love when people are telling me that. So, will cloud gaming end all platforms? That's an easy one. Now we can talk about more serious things. About Shadow, which is much more interesting. Someone in the audience asked me, what is Shadow? And that's a question I'm much more comfortable to speak of. And to explain to you first, who in the audience know about Shadow? Please raise your hand. Nice, thank you. So 2 years ago, it was not the same. We did not have this brilliant marketing to make sure that every one of you know about Shadow. So 2 years ago, well, even 2 years and a half ago, nobody knows about Shadow, and we started, and we asked a few of journalists to show them the first alpha version of what we built, to show them that cloud gaming was possible, that cloud computing is a thing. And so to attract journalists, we told them, come on, you will see something marvelous, a new tech you never saw before. And there is champagne, of course. So, of course, everyone told the journalists that there is a new tech that they never saw before and that there is champagne. So they're coming for the champagne, hoping that the speech will be as short as possible. And we did a conference de presse. So the conference de presse, you need to think you're one of those journalists 2 years ago, knowing nothing about Shadow, ready to know what is Shadow. It was the 20 October of 2016. And, you know, now we are big, I will explain how. At that time, we were very small, we were 10. I had to do the slides myself. I'm not very good on PowerPoint, as you can see. And to explain Shadow, I did myself the image. So, normally a computer is made from a desktop tower, a wire, and the screen. With Shadow, wait, animation, you remove the wire, you use internet instead of the wire, and you can use a screen far, far, far away. And then after, you can erase the other screen. So that's cloud computing. It's super easy, super simple. You can put the components far away in the data center and use internet as a link, as a connection from the screen, from the device to the machine. So, when we thought we had this idea, of course, we ran to everyone saying, we invent the cloud computing. 2 years ago, it was not like today, we'll come back to that, but 2 years ago, no one thought that cloud computing will work. And actually, when we run to cloud experts, or future experts, there are some experts of the future that can tell you if your idea is good or not. So when you run to those people, they told us that it already exists. And that it's been 30 years ago. You already have that at university. You can use a computer to access, you know, the big machine from far away. And on top of that, it's not working. What does it mean that it's not working? It means that you cannot, in B2B, you have only 4% of the computers that are cloud computers. In gaming, there's a lot of attempts and a lot of failures. I mean, you have latency, you have bad image quality, you have bad experience. Basically, it's not smooth. It's not like a local computer. And basically, cloud computing is not like a local computer. It cannot work. You cannot send 4K image into a link that is too small. So why we did it? So that's not for today, but if you're interested, when someone told you that you should not do it, and I think you all know about that because you're creators, most of you, you should do it. If you think that it's possible and everyone tell you it's not, well, that's a good idea to go there. If everyone say it's the best idea ever, probably someone else got it and made something great of it. And on top of that, if someone told me you're not able to do it, that's a big thing to, le même, t'es pas cap, en fait, ça marche bien. So, we gather a team of super big developers. It's not their real face, but they're more fat with beards and, you know. But still, in my heart, they're looking like that. So we gather a team of developers and we build it. And what we build is that. This video, it's one guy with three white knights that did it all alone. We are doing all those kind of things at Shadow. I mean, we're making sure people are slaves and working all night to do things. That's great. It's working well. Well, anyway, to make it work, basically what we did is the first high-end computer that will run exactly like a local computer. It's a computer that is not really there, but you will feel like Martial said, you can play every game up to 4K, up to 144 frames per second, and you can do even pro gaming on it. Well, almost. We can come to that later. Anyway, to make sure it's working, it's very complicated. I can talk a lot, and I will be really happy if one of you have questions about that, about the technology inside. You just need to know that there are six kind of components. And the most critical ones were the servers, the hypervisor, and the middleware to make sure that that we had something new, patents, and everything to make sure it's working. And where we are right now, it's basically more than 200 people, more than 65,000 users, and something that actually is working. So if you wonder if the cloud is working, you can just look at this curve, which means it's working. So now back to the question. It's a brand new world, and not just because some guy is doing a VR with a garland in his hands. It means that basically, this idea we had 2 years ago, a lot of people got it now. And why? Because if you think about that, gaming, that's the cheapest entertainment ever. I mean, you're paying 30 euros to play for 1,000 hours. And for example, if you compare that to just drinking a beer in a bar, it's much cheaper. Yet some people are still drinking in bars. Well, the issue with that is that you actually need to have a 1,200 euros PC or a gaming console that worth 400 euros to access this entertainment. So basically, there's a big barrier to actually run your game. You cannot just buy the 50 euros game and play. Thanks to the cloud, you can remove this barrier with something like Shadow that you will pay 30 euros per month with a Netflix kind of services. You can access every game directly by spending only 50, 60 or 70 euros. So you expand your market, the gaming market, by 10 times, by 20 times. I mean, there's a lot of people with style that will explain you, like Morgan Stanley, that this is the future of entertainment. Gaming is the future of entertainment. So suddenly Microsoft, Google, Amazon, Apple, everyone says they have something for 2020 to go for cloud gaming. And what is their goal? Basically, you have 2 billion gamers. Those 2 billion gamers is 200 million consoles, 300 million PC, and 1.5 billion mobile. I didn't count them myself. I mean, someone told me those numbers. When you develop a game, you will develop it for those people, basically. Console players, not you, of course, but console players, PC gamers, you are not able to develop a game that is really demanding also for smartphones, also for mobile. You need to adapt your development. You need to do something much more light. That's not a good English, but whatever. At the end, with cloud gaming, you can access this 1.5 billion mobile gamers. So suddenly, again, the people able to use your games, it's not just 200 million if you're doing console games, or 300 million if you're doing PC games, but 2 billion people. So the goal for Google, and the claim goal for Google and everyone, is to create the Netflix of video games, and to do it a bit like Netflix, aiming for a single platform that will gather all users and actually control the content and the distribution. That's a kind of way to see the future that is not really the real one. Basically, if you talk with Microsoft, you have two kind of console. You will have the low price, low level cloud-based console that basically give access to low level games. And you will have the high price, high performance hardware-based console that for most, I mean, rich people can afford competitive games and more EV games. Basically, you differentiate the couch gaming and the competitive market. And you say that you have two kinds of people. What we think is that players don't have to choose and don't want to choose. I'm playing competitive on Civilization, but I'm playing competitive nonetheless. I want to also play couch gaming. Every pro gamers I know are console players also. Every people that got a 2,000 euros computer or 1,200 euros computer usually also are happy to buy a console. So there's no need to choose. What the cloud should be, it's love, sweet love. It's a place where we can co-create, where we can play with everyone, when we can develop our own content and make sure it's distributed the way we want. It's the freedom of use to any platform. Basically, and we start to work with studios on that. When you look at the cloud just as a Netflix of video games, or when you look at the cloud just by being the future of computer, you're missing a lot of what the cloud could do. If you think about that, basically, you can have on Fortnite 1 million players all together because every player are on the same place and they are exactly where the server is. So you don't need to have latency issue or synchronization issue when someone move and need to adapt to everyone else. Same, if you look at the racing game, we were talking with Trackmania, with Nadeo. He explained to us that he cannot put more than 13 cars on the starting line, because every time that someone is turning, he needs to send to every other car the information. And at the end, there's a lot of synchronization needed between every cars. So it's limited. But if you think again on a cloud platform, you have every car that are on the same position and you don't need to synchronize between all of them. So you can do a game with 1,000 cars with the friends against the UK, for example. Like everyone can jump in. And you can remove the limits of video games. You can do a online world that will still be alive when people are disconnected. Because again, the servers and the players are in the same position. And that's what we want to do. What we want to do, and what the cloud should be, is not something that is directed by someone, by one big players, but it's a place where we can all create together. And so we proved, we still have a lot of work to do, but we proved that cloud gaming is a thing. Cloud gaming is working. Cloud computing can be used by people. But we can go much further. And to be honest, we need you for doing that. That's why we start to work with studios. We can show that actually anyone can create this content, that the studios can create their own contents and distribute it the way they want, because they know better what the player wants to do. We can create games that will be on mobile, on tablet, on console, on PC, and that can jump from one to another. We can create a lot of unique content thanks to the cloud, and we want to develop it with you. So if you know Shadow, if you're a developer of video games, if we want to partner with a lot of you and find a way to see what the cloud could be. So the answer is no. Of course, platform will still exist, and we have a lot of those, because everyone can create his own platforms. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a ton, Emmanuel. Does anyone in the room have a question for Emmanuel? Don't be shy, come on! Probably, I can translate.
Est-ce qu'on peut, avec un PC Shadow, jouer en coop, donc avec plusieurs manettes, 3, 4, sur le même support? Et comment ça se passe pour les jeux qui sont compatibles, évidemment?
Alors, je ne suis pas sûr d'avoir complètement compris. Est-ce que ta question, c'est est-ce qu'on peut faire jouer à plusieurs sur le même écran, ou est-ce que la question, c'est qu'on peut, en fait, comme quand on était petit, avec des split screens, etc. Alors, c'est marrant parce que non, tu ne peux pas. C'est mal, c'est interdit, et puis il n'y a pas la fonctionnalité. Mais en fait, on vient de développer le truc. Donc, on va le lancer, mais c'est secret. Donc, on ne peut pas le dire encore. On va le lancer dans 3-4 semaines, normalement. Mais oui, c'est un truc assez marrant. C'est-à-dire que justement, un des usages du cloud, c'est de pouvoir retrouver... Tu peux jouer par exemple à Apex ou à Fortnite sur une même télé avec deux ou trois players en divisant l'écran comme quand tu joues à Mario Kart quand t'es avant, finalement. Et n'importe quel jeu, finalement, tu vas pouvoir faire du coach gaming sur un seul écran en divisant par le nombre de joueurs. Mais il y a plein d'autres choses que tu vas faire de la même façon, tu vois. C'est pour ça que je disais que ça développe les usages. Tu vas pouvoir commencer à passer des soirées avec tes amis sans qu'ils soient à côté de toi en partageant ton écran ou une partie de ton écran et en ayant toujours à côté, effectivement, ce qu'il est en train de faire. En partageant les contrôles aussi, tu vas pouvoir jouer à sa place ou l'aider à passer des niveaux ou tout d'un coup, pendant que je suis en train de faire mes mails et en train de travailler parce que je suis quelqu'un de très important, je vais pouvoir aider mes développeurs qui sont en train de jouer parce que eux, c'est moi. Et donc, je vais pouvoir jouer avec eux. Donc, plein de choses comme ça, il y a de nouveaux usages en fait qui sont créés.
Does anyone has a French question or English question, Spanish question? We'll take all of them. No one? I'm a good student, so I had prepared questions for you.
Oh my God.
I wanted to know, you know, I think Shadow Sculpture is really about, you know, super technical stuff, but also like nonsensical fun. And I wanted to know how you mix that in the office on a day-to-day basis, how you can mix these two things that seem a bit contradictory in a way.
Thank you. That's a very good question.
I have another one.
You know, every startup wants to change the world. That's in its heart. And I mean, if you don't want to change the world when you're building your startup, you're missing something, of course. And usually when they grow up, they want to do something else than changing the world. But still. So from the beginning, we try to do our company and the kind of company we want to build. And actually how we can come to the office on Monday without having the feeling that two-thirds of our lives we will work. And how we can actually create something. And then something that is shared by everyone in the Paris office, but also in the Mountain View office. And when you share probably you all know about that, but I'm not talking about how boring is the job of you, because if we are here, because we like it, we like having fun. And so everyone wants to build something here and go in the same direction. It's the fun is natural. What is less natural is how to build with your community. That was something very strong from the beginning. We need to build with the community. Not from, I don't really believe in the community participating on the project and telling what kind of features you need to develop. But I really believe that when you build something, you need to make sure that people are using it. You need to use it yourself and you need to see what are the reactions. So one of the first things we put is that instead of having a roadmap and showing the roadmap to me and me yelling on people when it was not done, the roadmap is shown to the community. And putting the developer in front of the community when he's late, well, he's not late anymore. Well, he tried not to be. We are usually late at Shadow. But he tried not to be late anymore because, you know, you have suddenly 10,000 people that are just waiting for the development and that are eager to know where you are. So that's helping a lot also to having this feeling that it's a company where everyone works together.
Super interesting stuff. Any other question? Probably.
Hi, my question is about, so right now I'm a Shadow customer and right now...
Well done.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And right now...
And it's working?
It's working very,
it's
very well.
Great. Thank
you. Right now, the system works, you are mostly, or the part of the business I know is mostly like me, individual users who are using the service, they subscribe. Do you have plans to open this to organizations? For example, if I have, I don't know, I need 30 computers, I need more than just one computer, and also another possible development, or I don't know if it's something you're working on. What about the family computer where you have several accounts connecting to the same basically cloud computer? It looks like the same computer. Everyone has his own session, but it's kind of the same files, the same access to the same machine, basically, as if it was a family computer.
Well, that's in our plans, but not for today. We are 200, but actually we are only 200, and we need to focus. And yes, we got a lot of demands from, not demands, well, askings from a B2B, and from parents d'élèves, for example, that would like their children to not play after 8. And, you know, a lot of people like that. And yes, basically what we're selling is a computer, so there's a lot of usage. And actually, almost 10% of our users are non-gamer people and are using some new functionality of the computer of being able to have a non-personal computer. Basically, they start their computer and they send it to someone else that can go on working on it and send it back to, well, you can do ping pong with the computer, that's quite fun. Anyway, there's some new usage there. We want to go in this direction one day and to start to do it not going too far away from the gaming, we want to do it with actually to start with gaming studios. For example, for gaming studios, you know, the development of a game can be quite long. And when you spend 2 years on a game, then you want people to try it and to do the alpha and journalists and bloggers to test it. But actually, you need to do this last mile where everyone, when you need to check every configuration, because if you send it to the journalist will just not work because, of course, his configuration is a bit different. So we had a lot of studios, not a lot too, but still. We had two studios that start to using it to send it to journalists. By developing on Shadow and sending to the Shadow computer to journalists because they know the game will work and they know the environment when the journalists will actually use the game. So actually here, we can have a center point between the B2B that we want to go one day and to see how we can go there and the gaming world. And to know, and it's more close to us, and so we can start to work with studios and try to equip studios with Shadow and see how it's working, what they need, and enter this kind of world. Yes, that's something that we want to do. If someone here is interested, we can talk about that. And we'll be very happy to do beta and see what the needs of people is.
Thanks a lot, Emmanuel. Huge round of applause.